we'll start with digital transformation framework. Digital transformation is necessary to not only change, but also upgrade and update the existing systems that the organizations are following to run their business, right? So for that, why this digital transformation is necessary? Because there are a number of changes which is happening in the external environment, as a result of which it becomes absolutely necessary that the companies or the businesses, they adapt themselves with reference to whatever changes happen in the external environment. For example, the customers nowadays are looking for instant feedback or instant reply from the company, which can happen only when the company is connected online with the customers, right? Otherwise, it becomes difficult for the company to manage immediate interaction with the customer. So this is a small example which I can give it to you. The next is, we'll go through the first few initial lines. Successful organizations operate with a clear vision of where the business is going, what it needs to achieve, and how it intends to get there. A business model, right? Then comes your operating model. So we have a business model, we have operating model, and we have transformation roadmap, right? Business model generally relates to the manner in which businesses generate revenues, right? So that is what is business model. Operating model is the manner in which the business operates. For example, if a business is into manufacturing of a product, so how does it operate its business? Manufacturing, earlier it happened by the way of ordering the raw material from the market. They had their own set of vendors who used to supply the raw material. The raw material was then converted into finished goods. The finished goods were then stored into the inventory or the warehouse of the company, from wherein they were then transported or shipped to the market to various wholesalers, distributors, and retailers. Now, all this entire way in which the company was operating, this then became, this was done manually actually, but then this entire operational, this entire chain then became online. That is what is your supply chain management. I hope you might have heard of it, students. Have you heard of this term, supply chain management?
Yes, ma'am.
So in under supply chain management, what happened is if an order of the raw material has to be made, it is done digitally or electronically, as it is spoken of in technical terms, right? So the order is sent through your online platform and it transmits through your email, or there may be an online ordering form that is filled up and sent across to the list of vendors who are already a part of the system of the manufacturer. The quantity is specified, the time of delivery is also specified. The raw material moves into the manufacturing plant, from wherein, again, the capacity, all of these terms, a number of terms that I'm talking to you about will be reading in your operations management. But why I'm giving you a background, because you need to know what this operating model is all about, right? And how this is linked to your digital transformation. Now, once the order is received by the vendor, they start preparing to send the order within the time. The order reaches the plant, the production planning manager, he then gets it stored in the inventory of the raw material. And accordingly, the people who are involved in the manufacturing of the finished goods, they take out the raw material as per the requirement. Now the production process happens, the raw material is converted into finished goods. The finished goods are then further given certain numbers and they are stored in the inventory of the finished goods. Now from there, how is it shipped to the distribution network? That means the chain of your wholesalers, retailers or distributors, they then place the order with the company, which is again manufacturing company, to send across or ship certain requisite quantity of the units of finished goods at before the specified date. So the arrangement is then made to ship a number of units. The packaging is done by packing the number of units together, and then it is then shipped across to either the wholesaler or the retailer or the distributor, whoever has placed the order. From there on, it is then sold to the end consumer, right? So that is how the operating model happens. So one is your business model. Business model includes how the revenue is generated. That means whether you generate revenue by selling it through the shops, you generate revenue by selling it online, or you may be generating revenue by, just a second, student. Just hold on. Sorry. So we have then, therefore, the business model, we have operating model, that is how the entire business is operating. And then we have the transformation roadmap. Transformation roadmap generally principally deals with what are the adjustments that are required to be made with the changes in either the manner in which the business is being run by most of the organizations, or the manner in which the customer's expectation is changed. So accordingly, the transformation needs to be first studied by the top management of the organization, of the companies, and then accordingly, they have to integrate the important aspects which are going to immediately affect not only the running of the business, but also it is going to affect the revenue. So business model, operating model, and transformation roadmap are all vital for almost all the companies, along with the ability to solve the problems, defend against the threats, and exploit opportunities through innovative integration of digital technologies. Right? Now, again, there are so many words that are thrown across in this paragraph. One is ability to solve the problems. So one of the problems which I mentioned by way of example that I gave to you students is in terms of the customers looking for immediate feedback or immediate reply from the company executive. So this is one issue which is very often faced by the company because of the prevalence of your online platform, and as more and more customers are getting used to becoming online users, it becomes absolutely essential for companies to think in this area of integrating their business to make it online, right? So they need to have an online presence, and that is where this digital marketing comes into picture. But to make themselves available online, they need to transform some of the existing systems. For example, the customer service or customer care department, that needs to be transferred completely into an online mode. Rather than a customer calling through telephone, they just need to log into a platform from wherein they can interact with the customer care executive and receive the services immediately. So that is the transformation that needs to happen. Am I clear so far, students?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So for solving the problems, the transformation is there. And what type of transformation we are talking about? We are talking about digital transformation. Then to defend against the threats, because there is so much of, so fastly the market is changing and adapting the digital aspect of doing business. If you are a company who have not yet even thought of integrating digital platform as a part of your business, then you will be left somewhere behind and you will be taken over by a number of your competitors. So it becomes important for you to upgrade your business accordingly. Since we are talking of this transformation under the topic of digital marketing, so upgradation over here means digitalizing your marketing or selling process so that you can play safely against your competitors. So that is what is defending against the threat is concerned as. Exploit opportunities through innovative integration of digital technologies. What type of opportunities can be exploited? A new platform has emerged by way of online selling, right? So this is a channel or marketing channel which has emerged quite recently in the sense maybe it is there for the past 7 to 8 years, but then this is a new form of your marketing channel which is being explored by almost all the brands which are existing in the market. So they have an online presence, they have a presence on the e-commerce platform from where the online users can order the products. So that is what is exploiting opportunity is being done through innovative integration of digital technologies. A common digital transformation framework helps them to achieve all of these things. Ability to solve the problems, defend against the threat, and exploit opportunities. The framework is also known as Thrive. Is made up of 6 digital transformation guiding principles. So this each of the letters of Thrive word, there are 6 letters, they form the 6 digital transformation guiding principles, which every organization need to consider when embarking upon or when thinking of transforming their business processes. So this framework, digital transformation framework of Thrive, it was developed by Rob Levin from CXO Transform. This is a framework where T stands for transformation, H stands for holistic, R stands for response, I for innovation, V for value, and E for enterprise. So we'll go one by one with each of them. So we'll start with transform. Before that, little bit of more introduction. Thrive is not related to any one technology or industry. It is a way of thinking and approaching transformation from a business perspective. So it is not this model which has been designed by Rob Levin. This is not related to only IT industry. It is applicable to any other type of industry as well. For example, your petrochemical industry, your steel industry, anywhere this model is applicable. So that is the meaning of it is a way of thinking and approaching the transformation from a business as a whole. Business can be of any type. It is a practical digital transformation framework which provides leaders with a body of knowledge and roadmap to help them independently lead their transformation. This framework enables transformation leaders to analyze the entire transformation process in the context of their own internal environment and position in the market, which is your external environment. Clear, students? So they need to analyze it before thinking of or before designing the entire process of how they will bring about that change in their existing business process. Transformation, as we discussed a little bit yesterday, is the change. But it is not exactly the change, because you need to do a lot of preparation before adapting that change. So that whole procedure is what is known as your transformation, digital transform. And digital transformation means the whole process of making your business completely online. That is what is known as your digital transformation. From the business models influenced by the new digital capabilities, through to the successful execution of transformation strategy, Thrive provides leaders with a practical framework for a shared understanding of their organization's need to truly transform and thrive and in what is said to be dramatic decade ahead. We'll start with the T, which stands for transformation. It is fundamental to the Thrive Digital Transformation Framework, because leaders first need to recognize the fundamental difference between change and transformation. That is what I explained to you a few seconds back. You need to understand the difference between change and transformation before they can lead their companies on the journey of legitimate business transformation. While change is required to maintain and modernize an organization, this is not enough to sufficiently elevate both its internal capabilities and external offerings, right? So the difference between change and transformation is, change can only happen. See, there are a number of things that you as a leader should keep in mind while you are planning to change your business, the business processes. The reason being, a number of other employees are there who are part of that business process, running that business process. So immediately that change cannot happen. There are chances that you may have to train some of those employees to make them, to make their knowledge and the manner in which they can operate the advanced version of the business process more effectively. So you need to enhance the skill set as well. So that is what is known as your transformation that needs to happen. You can change the business process, but it cannot be done abruptly, or it cannot be done in a short duration of time period, maybe 2 months or 3 months. It takes adequate amount of time. And as things need to be transformed, they need to be planned before adapting the change into the current business process, so that you can come out with a better run and a digitalized business process. Am I making sense, student? Samajh mein aa raha hai?
Yes, ma'am.
Change or transformation ka difference samajh mein aa gaya? Yes or no? Okay. If you have any questions, you can ask me in between. Okay? Interrupt karke aap questions pooch sakte ho. Right? Okay. So while change is required to maintain and modernize an organization, this is not enough to sufficiently elevate both internal capabilities and external offerings. Sometimes what happens, the company has not adequately analyzed the situation. I mean, the whether situation as in whether they should be changing their business process or not, right? For example, there are certain businesses, businesses which are of very small scale, small businesses. Now, there is no need for them to get connected through internet, to connect their business process through internet with their business partners, because they are working in a very small scale environment. But yes, for selling, they may approach or they may like to target the various e-commerce platforms so that their products will get a new market wherein they can increase the sales of their product and hence increase the revenue generation for their company, right? So entire digitalization of business process for them is not necessary, but digitalizing the manner in which they're selling the product to the customer, that is essential for them. So that amount of understanding needs to be taken care of, especially in this first T of your Thrive model, that is transformation. Whether it is really adequate for your business to become completely digitalized, or you need to digitalize partially some of the parts of the business process. Now, if I'm talking of business process, I don't know whether I mentioned it in your class, when an organization is running, right? There are a few individuals who are selling the product who become part of your sales and marketing department. So selling or marketing the product, that is one aspect of the business process. Similarly, the same company may be manufacturing the product, right? So production department, which includes procurement of the raw material, manufacturing the goods, and storing the finished goods at the inventory, that is another part of your business process. Right? Then you have so many number of personnel whom you need to employ in your organization so that your different business processes can be managed efficiently. So for that, you will require few individuals who will take care of the different aspects related to their working or their salaries. So for that, you have your human resources department. So these are some of the different types of business processes which exist in any company, right? And there are a number of activities which are being done by each of these business in each of these business processes. They are known as your business activities. Correct? So that is why I'm telling you, under the transformation stage of your part of your Thrive model, it is important that the top management sit and think over which is the business process that they need to digitalize, or do they need to digitalize all of the business processes. So that they have to analyze, keeping in mind whether digitalization is going to elevate their internal capabilities, that is functioning within the organization, or will the digitalization help them with the external environment. That means staying ahead with the competitors or catering and servicing the customers in a more appropriate and a very efficient manner. To take advantage of the opportunities and protect against threats that the new digitally enabled business models present, leaders need to commit to being bold and transformational, digitizing at two speeds ahead of those that remain safely within their comfort zones and traditional slow ways of working. Then we come to the second word of the Thrive digital transformation framework, which is holistic. Holistic, as the name suggests, is the overall change that is required to be done. So the change that we are discussing about over here is your digital transformation. The word holistic is integral to Thrive digital transformation framework because, unlike business process reengineering, which focuses on business processes, this BPR, have you heard of this word, students? Business process reengineering? Suna hoga? Yes or no? नहीं सुना है तो नहीं
नो
बोलो.
मैम,
अच्छा ठीक है. सो यू
नो
ऑल्सो
मैम,
हैव अ सब्जेक्ट. हाँ यू ऑल्सो हैव अ सब्जेक्ट MIS, मैनेजमेंट इंफॉर्मेशन सिस्टम. होपफुली देयर यू विल बी गिवन एन इंट्रोडक्शन. बट बिजनेस प्रोसेस री इंजीनियरिंग इज अ मेथड इन विच द डिफरेंट बिजनेस प्रोसेस. अभी मैंने बताया बिजनेस प्रोसेस क्या होता है. जैसे आपका HR डिपार्टमेंट है या फाइनेंस. आई मिस्ड आउट द फाइनेंस एंड अकाउंट्स डिपार्टमेंट विच इज अगेन वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट बिकॉज जब तक पैसा नहीं आता, बिना पैसे के आप बिजनेस रन नहीं कर सकते हो. सो इट्स इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर यू टू कीप अ टैप ऑन द एक्सपेंसेस दैट आर बीइंग मेड एंड हाउ मच रेवेन्यू इज बीइंग जनरेटेड सो दैट यू कैन प्रिपेयर द बैलेंस शीट एट द एंड ऑफ द मंथ एंड सी वेयर डज द कंपनी स्टैंड, वेदर इट इज जनरेटिंग प्रॉफिट्स और इट इज एट अ लॉस स्टेज, राइट. सो दैट इज ऑल्सो इम्पॉर्टेंट. तो बिजनेस प्रोसेस में होता है जैसे आपका HR हो गया, एक एक हो गया आपका फाइनेंस एंड अकाउंट्स. Then you have, since you are procuring raw materials, so purchase department एक होता है, तो purchase से related एक business process होता है. Then for the manufacturing, you have an entire module which is devoted to the production department, and you have a module which is devoted to the sales department, right? तो इस तरह के अलग अलग modules होते हैं by which and it is a software program which is implemented within the company and which includes not only databasing the information of each of the department but also interlinking with each other. So that helps in smooth functioning of the organization. Now business process re-engineering is the method which helps company to study and understand the manner in which they are in the existing system, they are operating the entire business, and what are those areas where certain improvements or updations or upgradations can be made, right? After they have done the study, they come out with those specific processes, business processes where the changes are required to be made, and accordingly the software program is redeveloped for those departments. So that is, in simple, in layman's language, that is what is known as your business process re-engineering. That means you are trying to change, bring some change in the existing business process that the company is running. So unlike the business process re-engineering, which focuses only on the business process, or app development, which focuses only on the technology, or projects, which focuses only on producing outputs, because projects are generally tracked by in what amount of time you were able to complete the target that you had given to yourself of completing some specific work. Digital business transformation requires an integrated and holistic approach. That means all of these things should be taken together while you are looking for the digital business transformation. The reason being, once you go online, then in all probability, the entire, all the business processes will have to be connected to internet to make it a more smooth functioning process. Thrive helps leaders take a holistic and integrated perspective of the enterprise and its complexity, from digital business models, capabilities, and roadmap design, through to culture, portfolio governance. Portfolio is a set of activities that may be undertaken by different departments, and how those activities have to be performed, that is what deals with the governance. And transformation execution, leaders need to consider the big picture and not limit their focus to only some of the key enablers of transformation, because in the end of the day, just by digitalizing a single business process is not going to help the company to the extent if they digitalize the entire functioning of the company, which includes all the different business processes which I explained to you, whether it is related to finance and accounts or the purchase or your sales and marketing or even your production. So if they are digitalized, that means they are linked through internet, it becomes easier to transmit information or transfer information and also coordinate between the different departments. So holistic is the second important word of the Thrive digital transformation framework. The third word is response. CHR, so R is for response. It reminds organizations why and how they need to respond strategically to opportunities and threats they are presented with, both inside their organization and externally in the market. It's very important, students, for you to understand that if you are a leader of the organization, you cannot stay aloof as far as functioning of the company is concerned. You are connected with the market, and the market is extremely dynamic. That means there are a lot of changes that happens very fast in the market. And as an organization, you need to upgrade your current functioning so that you can meet the challenges which are being posed to you from the market, from the external environment. So that is why it is important that digital transformation happens in a particular manner. So internally, this could involve responding to evolutionary needs of the organization's culture, maturing the capabilities required to achieve transformation excellence, and the establishment of new governance that facilitates innovative transformation while minimizing bureaucracy. What is the meaning of minimizing bureaucracy? Bureaucracy means there is a set pattern which the employees need to follow to complete a specific work. So sometimes that set process may be a very lengthy process. Some of the employees, they might have a way of completing the work faster, but then they may have to exclude some of the stages which have been identified by the company. Correct? Like following the hierarchy. There are organizations who have open door policy. That means the executive need not report to the manager and manager to the managing director. Open door policy means even the executive can, if the manager is not available and if there is an urgency, the executive level employee can even contact the managing director. So bureaucracy is the set. The defined method that needs to be followed to complete certain activities in an organization. So that is being reduced if we go in for the digital transformation. So that needs to be analyzed. Internally, a lot of changes will be involved, including training of a number of employees to enhance their skill sets so that they are able to manage the business process more effectively using the digital platform. That is one aspect. There has to be a lot of psychological upliftment of the employees. The reason being, some of them may be too resistant to adapt the new technology. So for them, there has to be some psychotherapy sort of sessions so that they are able to very easily and comfortably adapt whatever changes are happening in their environment where they are working. So a lot of preparation needs to be done, and that is why transformation is the word that is used, and it is not just change. Externally, it could involve defensive and offensive responses to the changing dynamics of the market. Defensive and offensive means, the competition may be much more digitally advanced than you. So to defend yourself, you may go in for a digital transformation, which is the response that you are giving to the external environment. And offensive response will be, you may be trying to be one step ahead. That means you may be eager to explore something new that you can give to your customer. So that is also your response to the changing dynamics of your market. Caused by disruption or seizing the opportunities that digital technologies and new business models can be used to take advantage of. Does anyone of you know the meaning of this word, disruption? What is the meaning of word disruption? Anyone? A huge change that happens as a result of some of the changes, either in terms of technology or in terms of a development of a new channel of doing the business, right? So disruption means whatever the existing technology that was being used or existing channel or which was being used to conduct the business, the previous one gets completely outdated. So that is the disruption that is being caused. So when a disruption happens, it becomes absolutely necessary for the company to upgrade themselves. So that may be one of the reasons to respond to digital transformation. The fourth letter of the Thrive word is I, which is innovation. For transforming digitally, the company needs to be completely open to the new ways of doing business. So innovate new and innovative ways. So cloud, you have your cloud computing, mobile, the Internet of Things, robotics, etc., will bring about most rewarding business transformation. But when they are used strategically, that means you need to think whether are all of them required for your business or any one of them is sufficient to conduct your business more efficiently. Only through the innovative convergence of digital technologies can companies truly transform through new business models and ways of working. Innovation empowers companies to consider many new possibilities that can be part of its strategic response. And this requires effective approaches to innovation. Companies need ability to envisage, that means foresee, right? How new technologies can be converged into scalable architecture that is prepared for the near, mid, and long-term digital adoption. So digital transformation doesn't happen suddenly. It takes a considerable time period. So that is why it is written over here. Whatever the technology company wants to adapt to its business process, that needs to be converged into scalable architecture, means architecture of their business process, right? Which is prepared for near, mid, and long-term digital adoption. Next word is, of the Thrive word is V. Value. Whenever you go in for digital transformation, since you are doing a lot of thinking process, it's always better to understand what is value addition that you will be giving, not only to the customers, but also to your own business. So you have these two words, external value and internal value. External value represents the benefits transformation creates for it. External means from related to the external environment, and who is more important in the external environment? Your customers. While internal value represents the benefits delivered into the business as a result of transformation investment. External value is generated through digital business models shaped by strategic responses to what is happening in the market. That means since there is a lot of changes that is happening in the external environment, in the market, which is helping other businesses create extra value addition to the customers. So even you need to be in that race. So that needs to be analyzed, that what is the end value addition or what is value enhancement that you will be doing to your customers or to the markets. Customers doesn't only mean your end consumers, your channel members, your wholesalers and retailers. They are also your customers, right? So enhancing value to them is going to, in fact, carry forward the value enhancement to your end consumers as well. So wherever you find the opportunity as a businessman, you start contemplating about whether we should go for digital transformation or. So external value is generated through digital business models shaped by strategic responses to what is happening in the market. This enables companies to tap into the known and unknown needs of its current and potential customers in ways that create competitive advantage and seize the market share. Very important thing. For what? for profit making of any business. Competitive advantage, that means in the product category that you are dealing with, whether you are at number one position or number two position, right? Market share, what percentage of the market is purchasing your brand of product? That is the market share. Internal value is generated through initiatives that provide stakeholders with tangible and intangible return on investment. Who are the stakeholders who will be benefited by internal values? The people who are working in the organization. So they may be the employees, they may be your shareholders, right? The people who have done a lot of investments, the top management, they are all your stakeholders who are going to benefit from the internal value. This could involve higher revenues in a particular line of business or increased workforce capabilities that empower a company to undertake successful transformation and further increase internal and external value. Clear so far, students? Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
कोई doubt तो नहीं है बेटा अभी तक?
No, ma'am.
Okay. Then we have the last word of the Thrive Transformation, Digital Transformation Framework, and that is enterprise. Enterprise, as the word suggests, it is the entire company. So transformation must encourage, embrace, and educate people from across the enterprise and build a collaborative culture of new capabilities and mindsets. This is important. They must encourage, embrace, and educate people from across the enterprise. That is why enterprise is the last important word of the Thrive framework. To adapt a particular new system, it becomes absolutely essential for the top management to plan how they are going to make those changes in the people who are part of their business, right? So making this environment, which is known as your collaborative culture of new capabilities and new thought processes, which is mindsets. CEOs needs to foster a transformation mindset among the executive teams, which is aligned with the strategic aims of the company. This transformation mindset then needs to shape the company's culture at every level to create an environment within which innovation and digital transformation can thrive. Opportunities to upgrade the workforce, this I had already told you. Upgrading the workforce capabilities, that is enhancing the skill sets of your own employees. So opportunities to upgrade the workforce capabilities need to be identified, and people made to feel safe and comfortable about innovation, success and failure. That means you should make your employees feel safe that even in the case of unsuccessful implementation of this entire digital transformation, none of them will be thrown out of the company. That is how you make the employees feel safe and comfortable. The right external support and training is vital in helping to achieve this without unrealistically expecting an operational workforce to become overnight transformation masters. This is also very important to understand since the technology is new. The company, the management of the company should understand that they cannot expect very flying results just in overnight. Because the system is new, so it will take considerable amount of time for the employees to adapt to that particular. So this is another way of representing the Thrive model. It's in the form of a plant. You can read it on your own. I'll share the PPT with you. This brings an end to today's lecture.